Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and thank you so much for watching. For those of you who have never been to my channel before, my name is Debbie. So hi, nice to meet you. So for those of you who don't follow me on Instagram, quick announcement, I'm pregnant. Cue the little Instagram video.
How can I say what I'm feeling if I don't know how to move? How can I say what I believe in? Finally believe in you. I travel many roads, but I know one road to choose. Now my world is never changing. There's anything I can do, 'cause I found you. I found you, 'cause I found you. I found you, 'cause I found you.
So yeah, so the cat's out of the bag. I announced it on Instagram like about 2 weeks ago, but I wanted to say it here on YouTube since this is my first video back, so you guys would know and be updated with that. We're super excited and we can't wait to meet the baby. We're so excited to meet baby, but let's get to some makeup. I asked you guys on Instagram what you wanted to see in my next YouTube video, and I got a combination of summer look, spring look, glowy look, bronzy look, fast look. So my intention in this video was to do a combination of all those things, like a bronzy, summery, quick, easy glam. However, I got a little carried away. I got excited. I used a new palette for the first time in this video, and I was planning on just using like two shades and calling it a day. But I got excited and I was having fun doing my makeup, and I haven't done my makeup in a while. But I ended up doing just like a really pretty bronzy, just like summery look that you can wear like with literally anything during the summer basically. So if you're interested in seeing how I got this look, then just go ahead and keep on watching. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started, guys. Chris just brought me a quick coffee that I'll share with you very quickly because it's my new obsession. I talked about it on an Instagram story the other day, but I'll say it here again. You guys, I'm obsessed with coffee. All I do is drink black coffee. And I haven't been drinking that since I got pregnant because I try to like kind of avoid caffeine, not have too much of it. But I do have it every once in a while. So my cousin put me on this, and it is an iced latte with soy milk. So it's basically just soy milk with like a splash of coffee. It has like, I think, 70 milligrams of coffee in it or something. It's like a very small amount of coffee, and you're allowed to have like 200 milligrams a day when you're pregnant. So I don't have this every day, but I have it like maybe once or twice a week. But it's delicious because I hate sweet coffee. And what they use at Starbucks is a vanilla soy milk. So it has like that nice vanilla-y flavor, but it's not sweet. It just gives it like a little like, so it's not like bitter. Because I also hate iced black coffee because I think it's too bitter. But anyways, this is just like perfection. If you're somebody that doesn't really like sweet coffee, but you don't like black iced coffee because it's like, ugh, like too, ugh, you know what I'm saying? This is delicious, it's amazing, I'm obsessed with it. So let's go ahead and get into the video. I've been starting with the MAC Strobe Cream. You guys know I love, love, love MAC Strobe Cream, and it's just become part of like my makeup routine every single time I do my makeup. So I just get some on my hand as if it was like a moisturizer, and I just rub this in, focusing it on the high points of my face. So I kind of go like all here, like in a C. I'll go down the center of my nose, Cupid's bow, chin. I even put it in the middle of my forehead because I like to have kind of like that soft, dewy glow in the middle of my forehead. So yeah, I do avoid it on the lower half of my face and right under my eyes. And I actually just got out of the shower, so I just did all my skincare, so my face is like nice and ready to go. Normally, I would use, I'll show you guys what I use normally to prime my face. If I can, oh, it's right here. Sorry, I've got stuff like everywhere. This is how it is every time I do my makeup. I'm like, yeah, I have everything ready to go. And then I sit down, and by my first step, I'm like, I'm missing stuff. I can't do my makeup. Give me a second. So you guys know I have been loving the NYX Hydro Touch Primer. It's really affordable. It's really good. It's very hydrating. I normally put this down on my skin before I start my makeup. I didn't do it today just because I literally just got out of the shower. I did like a bunch of fresh skincare to my face, and my face is feeling like a little tacky from just all my moisturizers and my beauty oils that I put on. So I didn't feel the need to also put on a primer, but if you want to, you totally can. But I just put a little bit of the strobe cream on top of my skincare and call it a day. And then I'm gonna take a little bit of the Pixie Glow Mist and just spritz this over my face. So now we're gonna pop straight into foundation. So let me find my foundation here. I literally have like my little travel bag. Like this is what I've been doing my makeup out of lately, guys. And this is a combination of makeup, skincare, just like a bunch of stuff that I like to use. So my favorite foundation has been the Laura Mercier Flawless Lumiere Foundation. I'm obsessed with this. You guys know I'm a big fan of the Laura Mercier foundations. I love the Candle Glow Foundation, it's amazing. Then their Flawless Fusion Foundation for like a night out, absolutely incredible. But this one is kind of like if those two had a baby. This has like a light coverage. Like I would say like light to medium coverage, but it's very dewy and the smell. When you put it on your face, it smells like a spa. Like it just smells so good. So I'm gonna put two pumps of this, actually three pumps in the back of my hand. This is my Sonia Cashlook sponge, which is very dirty that needs to be cleaned. And I'm just gonna go ahead and start buffing this into my skin. I'm in the shade Latte 3N 1.5. And it's like perfect because it's very yellow. You know, I love really yellow foundations. They just like match my skin really good because I am a very yellow individual. So as you can see, just like with one quick layer, this side really looks so like nice and healthy and dewy. I have a little bit of dew on this side, obviously because of the strobe cream, but it just kind of like evens out your skin. It's so thin, it's so lightweight, it looks so good. It just does everything I want a foundation to do. And it's super lightweight. If you're looking for a full coverage foundation, this is not full coverage at all. Like I said, this is like a light to medium coverage, but I've been loving it. You do need to use a lot. Like I'm already on my fourth pump and I'm just starting the other half of my face. That pimple happened last night. I ate lobster bisque last night and I knew it. Every time I eat a cream-based like soup, like a lobster bisque or something, I get a huge pimple on my face. I'm convinced that I'm like lactose intolerant. Whatever. So that's that. I always take this down my neck, on my ears. I always make it a habit to take off my earrings before I start my makeup because it's so important to put foundation on your ears so everything kind of just like blends together. And you can see like this blemish is still popping through. I still have little things on my skin showing. It's fine because now when I go in with concealer, I'll fix all those little things up with concealer and I'll look like I'm very lightweight and like I'm not cakey, but I'll still have coverage in the places where I need it. Moving on to concealer. The concealer I want to use is not here. I'll be right back again. This is a disaster. Give me a second. So, I know I've been promising you guys this for a really long time and I haven't shown you, so I'm gonna take advantage and show you in this video. This is what I do when I want more of a full coverage concealer. What I like to do when I do my full coverage concealer routine is I like to do Tarte Shape Tape and Becca Ultimate Coverage Concealer mixed together, and I'll explain why as I do it. So first I'm gonna take a little bit of Tarte Shape Tape. I'm just gonna put a little bit right here under my eyes. You know that I don't use much of this. That's it. And then I'm gonna take the Becca Ultimate Coverage Long Wear Concealer. This is in the shade Banana. I am obsessed with this shade of concealer. This is the most yellow, most brightening, most beautiful shade of concealer that ever did exist. I'm just gonna put it just like that. So basically, I don't like to use this concealer all on its own because number one, it's very yellow, so I feel like it doesn't cut any of the darkness under my eyes. It's very brightening, but it doesn't get rid of like that little purpley type of tone you get under your eyes because it's so yellow, it just really brightens. And then we're gonna put a little bit of this blemish right here. Ooh, it hurts and everything. I hate those stupid pimples. It's like under my skin and I just wanna like, So I don't like using this on its own because of the color, number one. And number two, I feel like it's a very, very, very thick concealer. So when you use it directly underneath of your eyes, I find that it creases a lot. Like no matter how much you set it, it creases so much. So for me, my tried and true for right under my eyes, for covering up any darkness because it has a little bit of peachiness in it, and for not creasing is Tarte Shape Tape. Like Tarte Shape Tape to me is the only concealer that doesn't crease under my eyes and cuts the darkness under my eyes. Even though there's a bunch of concealers I love, nothing does it like Tarte Shape Tape. So I always put Shape Tape really close to my under eyes. And then I use this underneath of the Tarte Shape Tape to just brighten. So as you can see, I'm blending it out, but I'm not getting anywhere near my under eye area. I'm like really avoiding my under eye area and just blending this up towards my temple and the sides of my nose. And normally I use a smaller Sonia Cashlook blender that I have for this, but Olivia ate it the other day. I found it in pieces all underneath my makeup desk in my room and I was like, really? Really, bitch? So once it's pretty much blended out all the way, that's when I'll go and get in close under my eye so that I put the least amount of product in my under eye area, and then I'll use whatever's left over on my eyelid to kind of just like prime And that's it. Now we have a beautiful, bright, full coverage under eye. So now that we're nice and blended out, I'm gonna go ahead and set right under my eyes before I do anything else so that I don't get any creasing or anything under my eyes. And I'm actually gonna mix two powders together. And I've actually never done this before. I am gonna use a couple of new products in this video, just cause why not? So I have the Fenty, I don't know if you guys remember it in my Fenty wear test, I tried out the Fenty powder. I didn't love it in conjunction with the concealer. The concealer was just a little bit dry for me, but everyone raves and loves this powder so much, so I'm gonna give it another go. I did have to exchange it for the shade Butter. I had gotten, I think, the shade Banana. It was too dark. So this is the shade Butter. I'm putting a little bit of butter in here, and then I'm gonna take a little bit of my Maybelline Fit Me in the shade number 10, which is my tried and true that I love, and mix the two together. I'm gonna go ahead and buff out any little creasing that may have already formed in my under eyes. Pick up some of this powder. Here, I'm gonna kind of just blend it into my hand to make sure I'm like nice and evenly distributed on this one. And then we're just gonna press this in. Right in my under eye area and on the sides of my nose. And this looks beautiful. Wow, it doesn't look dry or cracky at all. It looks really good. As you can see, I really avoided my cheekbone area. I literally just put it right here and directly under my eyes so that I still have that nice dew from the foundation and from the strobe cream that we put underneath of our foundation. So you always wanna avoid your kind of cheekbone area with powder in general, because that will just mattify that area, and we don't want that area to be matte. So for contour, I'm gonna be using the Maybelline Superstay Foundation Stick. I love this foundation stick. This is in the shade Mocha. I don't remember if this is the darkest shade or like not like the second darkest shade. Like not the darkest one, the one under the darkest. I think it's the one under the darkest. But a little bit of this goes a long way. And this is one of my favorite things to use when you want like not so much of a contour. Like it does contour you, obviously it's gonna give your face structure, but this gives you kind of like a contour and a bronze all in one. So it kind of just gives your skin life and gives you color. So now I'm gonna take my little Real Techniques brush and I'm just gonna blend this out. And as you can see, a little bit goes a very long way. So be careful. So I always blend this out first with a brush, but as you can see, it's like super dark. It looks like I have a freaking bronzer helmet right now. Once you go over it with a sponge, the sponge picks up so much of the extra product. I just do this to kind of get my basic shape around my face. And then I take whatever's left over on the sponge and kind of just go along my jaw, under my chin, and just kind of chisel a little bit. And with the sponge, this will blend everything out and make it look perfect. Okay, so my camera was running a little low on battery, so I went ahead and put it to charge. I threw on my eyebrows. For my eyebrows, I just used my Morphe brow gel or brow pomade in the shade Biscotti. And then in my really bald spot up here where I literally don't have hair, this is not dark enough. So then I use a little bit of the Anastasia Beverly Hills brow pomade in the shade medium brown to fill in that bald spot, because you know that's what it is, a bald spot. And then I went ahead and did this eye very quickly. I look really funny right now because I have one eye done. Like this side's like so glam and this side's like dead. So I was not planning on doing this much eyeshadow. I was planning on doing something really simple. And even though this isn't super crazy complicated, it is much more than I was planning on doing. But you know, it happens sometimes. What are you going to do? I haven't done my makeup in a really long time, so I guess I got excited. So for the eyes, I'm using the 35G Bronze Goals palette from Morphe. Really nice palette. It's like all neutrals and bronzes, and I was planning on just throwing one shade in the crease and like a pretty shade across the lid. And as you can see, that's not what happened. So we're just gonna go with it. I went into this shade right here first, and I just picked up a little bit on the brush. These shades are very pigmented, so be careful. So I'm just gonna tap off the excess of my brush, and I'm just gonna run this through my crease just like this. This shade is a little dark, so you wanna use a little bit of product at a time and like really blend it out. But when you go in with a darker shade like this and really take your time blending it out and using a little bit of product at a time, you don't have to use so many shades to kind of like gradate everything together. You just have to blend a little bit more, and for me, that's faster as opposed to going in with 17 crease shades, you know? I think Chris just got here. That's it. And then to buff out those edges, I went in with this really pretty, like just really light brown shade right here with the same brush. And I just went along the top edges to make sure it was nice and blended. As you can see, I'm not really like being super meticulous or perfect with this look. I'm kind of just like winging it, like, you know, whatevs. Doesn't have to be perfect. Cause it's kind of like a, you know, bronzy, whatever. I'm trying to make it seem like this is as effortless as possible, guys. I just went way too crazy with my makeup. I was not planning on doing all this, but it happens pretty random. I went in next with this shade right here, which is really nice and warm. So I picked up some of this, tap off the excess, and I'm gonna put this, I'm using just a smaller fluffy brush, and I'm gonna keep this more concentrated in my crease to just give the eye a little bit more definition. But I'm just doing a quick wash of this in the crease just to give the eyes a little bit of dimension. But I'm not really going crazy with this shade. I really did do this really quick, I swear, guys. This was like a quick 5-minute thing. And as you can see, I was very surprised. I did my face, because I normally always do my eyes first and my face makeup after so I don't get fallout. Because I was just planning on doing a quick crease shade and then like a shade across the lid. And I ended up doing all this eyeshadow and I had literally zero fallout. Like there's no fallout. This is the first time I'm using this palette and I'm super impressed. I'm very, very, very impressed. I'm gonna go into this shade right here, which is like this really pretty golden shade. So this shade with the brush, I will say it's very pigmented. It's really pretty, but you do have to like keep going into it. Like you're gonna see what I'm talking about. I'm kind of using this to like cut my crease. Like you see, I'm kind of creating like a line to give my eye a little more dimension. But like I really went into like the color, like I'm going like this in the shade and that's all the payoff I got. And then I have to go back in to start filling in. And now I have to pick up more. Like it's just a very tightly packed eyeshadow. So you don't get like from one dip a lot. Like you have to like use a lot of it. If that kind of makes sense to you guys, because it's like a little more tightly packed. Then I picked up a Morphe M433, which is just like a flat kind of fluffy brush. And I went into this darker brown shade right here. Tap off the excess. And I'm just gonna go kind of like in a V type of movement to kind of go up along my lash line. And then I'm gonna take a little bit into my crease right here on the outer edge. And then I'm always keeping my other fluffy brush close by to kind of like blend that with whatever's left over on that brush. And I'm just kind of packing this on the outer edge of my eye. So I know this looks like a very complicated, like, wow, smoky, done up look, but it's really not. It's pretty, I mean, I think that was pretty quick. So then for lashes, I'm gonna go ahead and pop on a pair of Kiss number 11s. You guys know these are my favorites. And these are a pair that I've actually already worn once. So I'm just taking the extra glue off of them. If you guys can give me any good glue recommendations, like eyelash glue recommendations, I would really appreciate that because I used to use the House of Lashes glue, but it started kind of like irritating my lash line. Like I started noticing that it just, like my eyelids would get really, really, really swollen the day after I used it. So then I switched to Duo, the one with the little green letters. And this was like my tried and true for quite some time. Like I've loved this glue for a long time, but lately I would say for like the last month it's really been playing me. Like it barely sticks. Like I don't know if they changed the formula or what happened, but like from the moment I apply my lashes I have trouble sticking them on. And before this used to be like gorilla glue, like they wouldn't move. And I don't know why now this glue is just not working good for me. Like not even just on me, on clients I've noticed that I have trouble like sticking the lashes on, when before it was like so easy for me to put the lashes on. I don't know what's going on. So yeah, basically with the eyeshadow, I kind of was like really messy in my crease, but then I used that glittery shadow across the lid to kind of clean it up and make it look like it's like really structured. See? Lazy girl tips, guys. Lazy girl tips. You're gonna see what I'm talking about. Like see how it's already like playing me here? Like why is that happening? So now for the lower lash line, I'm gonna go in with this really nice warm color right here that we have put in the crease. And I'm just gonna smoke up my entire lower lash line using a pencil brush. This is a quick step. And then to just add like a little bit of a bronzy shimmer, I'm gonna go in with this pretty bronzy shade right here. And I'm gonna put this directly on top of that color. Just add a little glitz and glam because you know, we already did like a full out eyeshadow look, so why not? And then, using a little pencil brush, I'm gonna go into this nice dark chocolatey shade that we used in the outer edge. And I'm just going to put this right here. just on the outer half of my eye. Let's finish up the face. We're pretty much done. So for bronzer, I have actually been loving this bronzer. This one's from NARS, from this little NARS Atomic Blonde palette. I just go into this bronzer. It's a little dark, so you don't need too much of it. And I'm not like super tan right now. So I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of very quickly go over the perimeter of my face with this, just to further bronze up my face a little bit. And then for highlight, since I'm already here, I love this highlight in this palette. The highlight is Last Call Highlighting Powder from NARS. I'm sure you can buy this as an individual, like powder. And I'm just gonna use this to kind of give me like an all over glow. It's so beautiful. It's like super golden. I love it. It's so pretty. So I'm putting this kind of like just on all the high points of my face, but very loosely. Like I'm not being super specific with it. For blush, I'm gonna go in with a little bit of Tau from the Juvia's Place palette. I love this blush. It's just so pretty and like peachy and happy. It looks like a Mai Tai. It's just like so good. I love it. And then because of course one highlight is not enough, I'm gonna go in with a little bit of Laura Geller Gilded Honey from this little palette that I have. I love this little palette. It was from their holiday collection and it comes with Molten Copper, Gilded Honey, and French Fizz. I'm just gonna put this just on the highest points of my face. And I'm also gonna use this to highlight the inner corners of my eyes. I love this highlight. This has like been one of my favorite highlights for I don't even know how long. It's just like the perfect like golden shade. Love it. And we're gonna put a little bit right here on our brows. Not on our brows, on our brow bone. I think we're ready to set our faces. So to set my face, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna actually use my pixie spray first. What I like to do with the pixie spray is just put it on the sides of my face. I avoid the middle of my face altogether with this because it does have oil, and if you put it in the middle of your face, it's gonna make your face look oily right here. We don't want that. And then on top of that, I'm gonna put the Morphe setting spray to just set everything down. For lips, I'm gonna go ahead and use the NYX Suede Matte Lip Liner in the shade, would be a good idea to tell you guys, in the shade Sandstorm. And I overline my lips like just a little bit, but not too much. And then for lipstick, I'm gonna use the Anastasia lipstick in the shade Nude. Which is almost the exact same color as the lip liner. Then we're gonna go in with a Baddest Beige right on top. Just to lighten it up a little bit. I don't know if you guys do this, but whenever I wear a lipstick, I put on like 17 shades of lipstick. Why I do that, I don't know. I wish I could tell you. And then I'm gonna go in with the Fenty Glow Gloss Balm right on top. So I'm gonna go figure out what I'm wearing, get dressed, come back, and then I'm gonna show you guys what I'm doing for my body glow situation. This is like my lazy girl body glow that I'm gonna do today because I don't have much time. I have about like 35 minutes to finish everything I have to do. So wish me luck figuring out what I'm gonna wear. Literally the first thing I tried on was perfect. I'll show you guys what I'm wearing very quickly. This is a little dress from Fashion Nova. I'm sorry, my boobs are in your face right now and they're like really big right now. And you can kind of like see, you can't really see from this angle, but I'm starting to have a little gut there. The gut is definitely coming out. But so for my body glow, what I normally do, like a Natasha Denona body glow, and then I like highlight and do all these like things. I put an oil on, I do all these steps, but this is like my lazy girl highlight. This is my, I'm in a rush. I wanna look nice and glowy, but I'm not trying to like do 900 steps and like I wanna look good, but I don't care that much if every angle is like perfectly glowing, you know what I mean? This is just like my quick glow. So I recently discovered this was sent to me by NPR and I was so excited to try it out, I love it. This is the Jergens Brilliance Skin Illuminating Moisturizer. It's a body moisturizer, but it has like little flecks, I'll show you guys, of like glitter in it. So I don't know if you can see on camera, it has like little reflex of actual glitter in it, but it's not like big chunky pieces of glitter. It's like little soft light pieces of glitter, and it just looks so, oh my god, my dress. It just looks so cute and pretty, and it looks really pretty in the light, like in the candlelight. It kind of just like shimmers. You can see the difference already in my skin when you put it on, and it's just lotion. It's literally just lotion, so it takes 2 seconds to put on. It doesn't stain your clothes, nothing like that. So I put this on first, and then I take the Laura Geller Illuminating Body Mist. And this is a really nice product. This doesn't give you like this crazy, oh my god, glow, but it gives you like a really nice, again, like that little soft, kind of like glittery, golden type of look. And since it is an oil, you see, I'm under lights right now. Like I'm in front of my ring light, so you can see it a lot more. But in person, it's more of like a soft, effortless glow, but I really like it. It looks really good. But anyways, this is the finished look, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it helpful. It's just like a really nice kind of like summery look. Skin wise, this is really what I've been doing with my skin for the last couple months. I ended up loving the 35G palette from Morphe. This has been sitting on my desk for like 2 months, and this is the first time that I used it here on camera, so that was pretty cool. It's kind of like a first impressions, but I love it. It blended so easy. I mean, I knew I was gonna like it because I love the Morphe shadows, but there was literally zero fallout, and I'm in shock. And I really liked the combination of the Fenty powder with the Maybelline Fit Me. It worked very well. Also, I don't know if it's something you guys are interested in, because I know I mostly stick to beauty stuff on this channel. I know I've done a couple of vlogs here and there of like home renovations and home decor, and I am gonna do an updated home tour very soon because we've done a lot in the house, and we actually just finished one of the bathrooms, and I did a whole vlog about that bathroom renovation. But if you wanna see some videos like about pregnancy, maybe a video about my first trimester, the different tests that you do during your first trimester, what to expect in your first trimester, how I was feeling, things like that. If you wanna see like some, I guess, mommy videos, I guess you would call them, I can totally do that for you guys. Just comment below and let me know. I just know if that's something that you guys are interested in seeing on my channel, but let me know, because that's obviously a huge part of my life right now. And I'd love to share it with you guys if you wanna know more about it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Comment below and let me know what you guys want to see in the next video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.